Subscribe to Upskill with Ritzy and click the bell icon for more notification on infotainment and education videos.
Hello all. My friends usually ask me that what are the few things that one should consider before buying a computer. So I'm going to answer this question. If I wish to buy a computer, I will select one that suits my requirements, which are designed and categorized with respect to their size, speed, storage, capacity, and cost. So yes, the topic for the day is categories of computers. So let's talk about the different types of computers, namely micro, mini, mainframe, and super. Let's start with the very first microcomputers. They are small in size and cost less. They are usually designed for personal use. Therefore, they are also called personal computers or PCs. Examples: Commodore 64, IBM PC. They are mainly used in homes, schools, offices, shops, banks. Following are the various microcomputers that are given different names according to their usage. Desktop computers. Computers which are designed to fit on top of desk are known as desktop computers. They come with several units such as monitor, CPU, keyboard, and mouse, which are connected to each other and work like one unit only. Laptop computers. They can be placed on the lap. These are battery operated and portable. By the word portable, I mean that they can move anywhere. We can move it anywhere. They are more costlier than desktop. When not in use, we can fold down the screen onto the keyboard. The screen usually ranges between 13 to 15 inch. Tablet computers, commonly called as tabs, are smaller and lighter than laptop. They use touch sensitive screen for typing and navigation. The screen size is 7, 8 or 10 inch. Reading ebooks, watching movies, viewing photographs, browsing internet are the popular uses. Palm top computers. It is a device that can fit in the palm of your hand. It has a compressed keyboard. Some of these computers replace a keyboard or mouse with a pen that serves as an input device. Handheld devices or PDA. The other name is personal digital assistants. Devices that can be easily held in the hand are known as handheld devices. Example, smartphones and tablet. They either have a touch-enabled display screen as an input-output interface or a simple display unit with a keyboard. Smartphone. It is a handheld device that combines features of a PC, that is personal computer, with other common features of a mobile phone. It can be used for making and receiving calls, text messaging, emailing, web browsing, capturing videos, gaming, etc. Game console. It is a device used to play interactive video games. It is equipped with a display screen, game controls which includes joysticks and buttons, and speakers. TV or a computer can be connected to it. Examples: Microsoft Xbox, Sony PlayStation, Nintendo GameCube, and Nintendo Wii. Embedded systems. The other name is microcontroller. It is the one that has a computer hardware with software embedded or implanted into a large device. It comprises of all the essential components of a computer like CPU, RAM, ROM, input and output medium, but does not have disk drive, keyboard or screen. It is designed to perform a specific task in various devices. For example, television, vehicles, telephones, digital cameras, washing machines, microwaves, printers, dishwashers, and medical equipment. Let us understand the concept with the help of an example. In a microwave oven, the role of embedded system is to take instructions from the user through the keypad, that is setting time and pressing the start button, and translating them into commands which are then passed on to the microwave to obtain the desired output and will stop as per the timing set. Mini computers. They are bigger in size than the microcomputers, typically being the same size as that of a refrigerator. They have a higher processing speed and are expensive than microcomputers. They are capable to support about 4 to 200 users simultaneously. They are used in banks, universities, and other big organizations. For example, PDP-8, HP-2100, Microvac-3100. Mainframe computers. They are very powerful. They are huge in size with a large memory and high speed. More than 100 users can use this computer simultaneously. They are used in network environment. They are very costly and mainly used for bulk data processing in large business organizations, universities, banks, scientific laboratories, airline and railway ticket reservations, stock exchange markets, etc. Example is IBM Z series, PDP-10 and System Z10. The last one is supercomputers. They are the most powerful computers with a huge processing speed. They are used for weather forecasting, space research, satellite control, and a lot more. Example, CRAY-1, CRAY-2, Param, Tihany-2, Sunway, Taiholite. The world's fastest supercomputer is Sunway Taiholite. China's National Research Center of Parallel Computer Engineering and Technology, NRCPC, developed it. Param is a series of supercomputers designed and assembled by the Center for Development of Advanced Computing, CDAC, CDAC India. The latest machine in the series is Param Kanchenjunga. Thank you so much, guys, for watching this video. If you loved it, kindly like and share. And yes, you can connect to me in the comment section below. Bye. Take care.